Hello friends, imagine you are sitting in examination hall and you find the very first question, compulsory question for 16 or 15 marks. You don't know, or you might have left it, or you find it is very tricky. So what should be your strategy at that point of time? So myself Nagbhushan Pai, so today through some of the videos which I discuss in the class as to how someone has to strategize during examination, I would like to tell you what should be your strategy in such situations. At the end of the video, I'm going to share my own experience which I faced in 2007 May examination when it came to costing paper. Yes friends, enjoy the video. So we'll take out question number 59. Please pause the video students, because we have come to the examination questions. You have to imagine now yourself sitting in the examination hall and you have got a question like this. So please do the working. 6 marks, 6 minutes, including time to read the question. See, this question has got a flavor of 109 also. What is the rule and the strategy I said? But here to go nowhere, no, this is only one question. We can't leave. Whatever you know. Don't spend time on thinking now. Because okay, you get stuck because of the first question. Forget second question, third question. What you know, just dump it quickly. Try to do the mark allocation. Take the, apply your judgment, how much effort is involved. Or foundation level. You say, what is this, sir? Why they are giving you this type of things at the final? Anyhow, we'll see. 6 mark question, examination November 20. Okay, those who have left deferred tax got stuck. They think that this is a deferred tax question, I don't know. But my simple strategy is, let it be anything. Write something, what do you know? You don't have any other option, remember. If you don't know, you don't know. Then what do you know? You write there, no? 1 mark also might save you somewhere. I told my experience, 40 marks costing, 1 mark less gone. One group itself is gone, okay. Now parent prepares the CFS of the group every year. During the year ended 31st March 2020, very important, note that period, that at the end of the year, 31st March 2020, certain events affected the tax position. As a wholly owned subsidiary of parent incurred a loss of rupees 20 lakhs, which is adjustable from future taxable profits of the company for tax. So there was one loss made by one of the subsidiaries. S Limited is unable to utilize the loss against the previous tax liability. Did we not solve this type of questions in Ind AS 12? Now the income tax does not allow S to transfer the loss to other group companies. That means it is to loss for it, it has to use only. Other profitable companies cannot take it. However, it allows to carry forward the loss to utilize against future profits. Understood. The directors of parent estimate that S Limited will not make any taxable profits in the foreseeable future. So, what are you supposed to do? On tax loss, will you have a deferred tax asset or liability? Asset. Why? Because you remember, taxable temporary difference, sorry, deductible temporary difference, MAT credit, tax loss. These three things results into deferred tax asset. But before recognizing deferred tax asset, you have to evaluate three things: taxable temporary difference, future profit, or tax planning opportunity. So taxable temporary, not there. Future tax planning, don't know. But they said, I'm not going to make any profits. So you have to write one single note that no deferred tax asset can be recognized by the group. Asset can be recognized by the group, parent limited. Why? Because at the subsidiary themselves, they cannot recognize. Then how can I recognize? Or at least subsidiary's loss can be transferred to other group company. Then subsidiary cannot recognize in its SFS. But a parent can recognize in its CFS. Follow? First of all, did you allocate the marks? How many questions are there?
Two, three.
two, three questions. Three questions. Okay. What are those three questions? First question is this. Then we'll see what we need to do. On 1st of April 2019, exactly at the beginning of the year, parent borrowed 50 lakhs in their standalone. The cost incurred by the parent arranging the borrowing is 1 lakh. What is this? This is the transaction cost. This expenditure is qualified for deduction under income tax for accounting year 1920. The loan was given for a 3-year period. Did you not do this type of question also in Ind AS 12? As per the agreement, no principal or interest was payable on the loan during the tenure of the loan. And you see the beauty, no? Same Ind AS 12 question was there, which they have given in your CFS. Or I don't know, this is come for exam. This may be a Ind AS 12 question. I have put in CFS. No principal or interest was payable on the loan during the period of the loan. But what you need to pay is a bullet payment of 65,21,900. As per parent, as per their imagination or their estimation, this equates to an EIR of 10%. As per income tax, further expense of 15,21,900. How do you get this?
65 minus 50
will be claimable from the income when the loan is repaid in 2022. Follow? Now the tax rate is 20%. Now let us come to the question. Explain. That means theory, not just calculation. And show. Show means calculate. See, they didn't use the word calculator. They should explain it. And show each of these events, how many events, 2 events, would affect your deferred tax liabilities in the CFS of the parent on 31st March. You have to first explain that. Explanation carry how many marks?
Maybe
1 mark, because this is a 6-mark question. And showing calculator carries you 1 mark. So, I can allocate either 2 mark for the first question, 2 mark for the second question. Then you are also required the third part of the question. There are 3 questions here. Examine means look very closely. Somebody is claiming something. Somebody is coming and telling this is ring is made up of original diamond. You are a goldsmith. You are given. You have to examine very closely the claim made by somebody. What is the claim here?
EIR
is 10%. The management is claiming and you are an expert. Somebody has bring that case to you. You have to examine closely and say whether effective rate arrived by the parent on the loan of 50, is it correct? Is that effective rate is correct? What they are claiming, you have to tell. Now, whether that 10% is EIR? Yes, you might end up with creation of IRR. Does it need it or some other way you can check? See, multiple ways you can check whether the diamond is or say gold ring is there. The gold is pure gold or not. You can check in multiple ways. What is that one way? You have some instrument with you. You rub and see. You see in this. That is one way. Or you melt it, entire golden ring. Then you understand the purity.
Or the mark.
You see there is a mark is there. You based on the mark. You go with the multiple ways. Okay. How do you justify whether it is 10%? You said IRR. Fine, go with the IRR. How much time it is going to take? Yes. Is there any other way I can justify whether it is at IRR? At a 10%. Yes, that's. Is there any other way? See, again, you only said, I can melt the gold, I can rub the gold, I can check for hallmark. Is there any other way you can find out whether it is EIR is correct, that 10% is correct? This one thing is you find out IRR. Option number one is IRR. None, okay. So option number two is present value of future benefits, future cash flows. Is there any other way I can try? But you will not get this. When you find out the present value of future cash flow, what you get is fair value, not initial recognition amount. Maybe you may have to deduct initial recognition amount, then you get that. Is there any other way? Simple way. Think simple. Amortization schedule. If they are claiming The 10% is EIR. You start with the original book value of the loan. You should end up with the amount to be repaid, 65,21,900 at the end of the third year. If their claim is correct, then your amortization schedule should tally. Do it. You understood how to understand a question. I'm explaining your question. See, there are three aspects of the question. In each aspect, there is an explain and calculate is there. And third, they ask you to examine. That means somebody is claiming. You have to give your opinion. To do that opinion, simply, is it that gold ring? Is the gold ring? You can't say it. You have to do some testing somewhere. Testing includes some workings. It is your choice. Somebody can test in the form of IRR, somebody can test in the form of present value of future benefit, somebody can test in the form of amortization schedule. You choose and give your justification whether the 10% is IRR, EIR or not. No questions clear? Then you say, this is correct. Or when you find out the present value of future cash flow at 10%, you should be getting 50 lakhs.
49 lakhs.
Minus transaction cost. Because fair value, you should be getting 50 minus 1, 49 lakhs you should be getting. Sorry, 1 is you deducted, no? Transaction cost is deducted or added? Borrowing cost is deducted or added? Deducting or adding? Adjusted means what? Add plus or minus?
Bank entry.
Go with the bank entry. Transaction cost to bank. Cash loan received, bank account debit, that means 49 net. Okay, that means when you find out the present value of the future cash flows at 10%, it should amount to 49 lakhs. That is another way, correct? Now understood? Let me explain now. That's what, no. Why you did not do it when I asked you to do? Fine, did you try IRR? Then what happened? Got stuck. See, this is the problem happens. We think, don't do. Why you are stopping? Because you think. It is a waste of time there in the examination hall. Outside you think, no, you have got a lot of time. In examination, life is very limited. Life is very short. It is very sweet. 3 hours only. Exactly 3 hours. In that time, don't waste time in thinking, no. Everything should be action oriented on that 3 hours. Now, what I say? I always say my Mula Mantra. Put everything what you know. At least you would have put some IRR or something you would have calculated. By the time I gave you some 10 minutes, you would have scored 2 marks. And my question, did you not know this? Did you calculate did you tell me carrying amount of the loan? What is the carrying amount of the loan? Did you tell me?
49
is the carrying amount. When you are supposed to calculate? Deferred tax? End of the March. Is it a big deal to calculate carrying amount at the end of the year? 49 into 1.1. 1 point interest, no? Did you pay the interest? Cash flow was there? See, followed? Okay, so now let us check the answer. And see, that is the examination question. You see how they trick. And suddenly from nowhere they have bought one new concept which we have not done in Ind AS 109. Tell me a single question or somewhere single thing in the study material, RTP, MTP, examination, wherever, where that last examination was there, that management has claimed 10%. Please examine whether their claim is correct. Have we come across anywhere? Now, Ulta will ask you, did we not know it? We knew it. But they asked us something totally different. Now, if you are not conceptually clear, you will not do it. You are conceptually clear, then you understand, sir, it actually is not three. There can be multiple ways. We may not have explored it. As of now, we explored only 3 ways. IRR, present value, amortization. There may be other ways also. Who knows it? But if we have applied anyone, that's sufficient. Yes. The first event, we say that there is a tax loss, which is going to create a deferred tax asset. But the tax base is, because carrying value is nil and the tax base is 20 lakhs, you are going to get a deduction of 20. To tell this, you might have got 1 marks. That I have got a tax base of 20, I am going to create a deferred tax asset on that 20 lakhs loss. However, since there are no taxable profits in the future, we are not going to recognize deferred tax liability asset in CFS. So, just to write these sentences, you would have got 2 marks, 1 or 2 marks. Now, did your answer cover that deferred tax asset is going to come on 20 lakhs? Did you say that we are not going to recognize deferred tax because no taxable profit? Yes. So, you end up getting 1 mark for a 2 mark question. Now, did they not ask you to explain and show? Sorry? This is the number, no? You should present some number, right? That might calculate me some numbers are going to come. With only with theory, they cannot say calculate. So you have to use that number somewhere. You say nil. Nil means what? Zero. Or you can present CA is zero, TB is 20 lakhs, deductible temporary difference is 20 lakhs, but deferred tax asset star and give one star here. Do the calculation and explain it. Follow? I can move to the next one. So, how many marks you scored? 1 mark. Calculation of deferred tax on the second case. So, what I need now? I need a canning amount. How do I find out the canning amount? I will find out from an amortization schedule. When I want the carrying amount? At the end of the year. End of the year carrying amount can be obtained only through an amortization schedule. But for this, I need opening initial recognition. At what value you recognize the loan initially?
49.
What is my EIR?
10.
As claimed by the management. So, your carrying amount of the loan at the end of the year is 53,90,000. Because you passed an accounting entry bank account debit to loan 49 lakhs. This 49 become opening balance. Interest at the rate of 10%, 4,90,000. CCF was nil. You got a closing balance of 53,90,000. Clear? I did not do an amortization schedule. I show explained in one form of line, one line. Now, second, what is my tax base?
49.
Now, did they recognize this as a part of liability, income tax, or did they give you as a deduction?
Deduction.
If they gave you as a deduction, it is not a part of my liability. Correct? Wait, one more thing. This point one, interest what you expense you claim, did they allow it as a deduction? No. So what is my tax base? So what amount you recognize, that's what amount they agree. So your tax base, because whatever 15,21,900, this 50,90,000, whatever that amount of interest, 4,90,000, like that every 3 years, it is deductible only when you are going to make the payment. Hence, the tax base today is only 50. You explain. Now, this is my working note one. So, we calculate the, clear? So, I will calculate the loan balance at the end of the year is 53,90,000, tax base is 50, temporary difference is 3.9, I calculate deferred tax asset. Can I calculate deferred tax asset? Sorry?
20%.
78,000. Now, can I calculate deferred tax asset? Recognize? Provided, I give a note. If there are future taxable profits, then I can recognize. But there is already loss, they said, no? Can I say that there is a loss I can't recognize? Why? No. Loss is where? Who took the loan? So when I have to see, should I recognize deferred tax asset or not? Whose profit I should be seeing? It's parents' profit. Have they told anything that parent has made a loss? No. So then I give a note. I'm going to recognize this deferred tax asset provided either there is a taxable difference or future profits or tax planning opportunity. That's it. 2 marks. Did you get this carrying amount? You can allot 1 mark to this. And rest of the portion, tax base, deferred tax, giving this note, explaining, 1 mark. What happened here? What went wrong? Don't tell me carrying amount went wrong. Yes, that's what you are going to tell. This is okay. Not okay. But not okay. How it is okay? Okay, means one mark. Our cost of that is 1 mark. Clear? Simple, no? Simple or difficult? Actually, very simple. Okay, now let us go to the third one. Examination of EIR. Management is telling 10%. How do I try? Let us start preparing amortization schedule. I go with the year 1, 2, 3. What is my opening balance? 49 lakhs. How much is my rate of interest? 10%, no? 4.9 lakhs. So, 53.90. This will become opening balance. Again, 5.39. It becomes 59.29. 59.29, 5.92, which I am going to adjust it. I get 65.21. Perfect. And this is the amount I am supposed to pay. That means management is correct. Somebody came to you with somebody's claim. You examined very closely by doing your test. And finally, you give your opinion. This is 1 mark. If you have prepared amortization schedule, or if you have calculated IRR, or if you have found out the present value of the future cash flows, you score 1 mark. Because examination cannot happen without testing. Then you will give your comment. Since the loan's closing balance at EIR of 10% is exactly matching with the bullet repayment of 65 lakhs, this means that the 10% what interest taken as an effective rate by the management is correct. 1 mark. Clear? Understood? Know how to use these verbs, what they give, and you see the tricks. And more importantly, this is what I always claim, and I love to say that we know everything. And that way I prove that knowing and writing are different. Understanding an examination is different. You know it. Tell me one thing which you didn't know. Everything you know. But how you present it one after the other systematically, that is practice. Mock test you have to give. Then you realize. And this is like a mini mock test. If I start doing it, okay, step number one, step number two, step number three, you will do along with me, you understand it. But when I say, that's why not even a single examination question I am solving, even though it is a very complex thing, I say plus you solve it. Whether that type of question I have solved or not solved. Because why? Because you have to have that simulation. You should feel what the student would have felt at that time. And other questions, okay. I will not give you any question straightforward, which I have not solved. But if it is an examination, irrespective of whether I have done or not, I am going to do it and you are following. Okay, it considers the impact of cost of borrowing on initial recognition. That loan processing fees, no? It is considered. That's why I have to give you one more examination question. You feel consolidation is easy. Now you don't have anything to say that, no sir, consolidation difficult, I have not understood. If you have, yes, please, you have got any doubts in consolidation? Tell me right now, before we proceed into the next question, you have to tell me, do you have got any doubts in consolidation? Don't tell deferred tax, I have already done deferred tax. Don't tell me, oh, if you have got any doubts, right now we'll discuss. Then you should not tell, sir. Adu, illa illa nivu. You have got any doubts? No? Like that, who will give you? Sir, I will read this question. Just I'll go outside and come now. In examination hall, will anybody allow you? What you know, you start, you have to start. So before that, you have got full opportunity, full chance. God has given you full chance. Before you enter the examination hall, you have got chance to refer anything, read anything, ask anything, everything. But once you get into that, you are not allowed that 3 hours. Now tell me before that. Do you have? No? So? Okay, chalo, your time starts. Please read the question. This is a how many marks question? 15 mark question on consolidation. Again, what you are going to feel now is exactly what other students have felt in January 21 examination. And we have seen already passed all the past 3 examination question on consolidation. Ditto copy paste. And now you see this question. Yes, please start. Start. And again at the end, after we solve, you are going to come with one statement. What, sir? So simple thing. Yes, we'll discuss, no? We'll discuss the solution. Do you watch cricket match? Do you watch cricket match? Sometimes. Yes, sir, no? Cricket? Yes, no? Sometime, bouncer comes. Did you observe the batsman? They will do one among the two strategies. What is that? When the bouncer comes? One person may bend like this. Correct, Oshivali? He will bend like this. Another person may send that ball to six. Now, the word cheers whom? One person, one who hides or try to escape. Word will, the crowd is going to clap. Ah, very good, we are busy and all. No, the word appreciates only the person who sends that bouncer to the boundary. Undisputedly, this was a bouncer. Very first question, compulsory question. Bouncer, clear-cut bouncer. And it was a strategy of the bowler. Clear-cut, first, very first bouncer they have given. Now everything lies on the batsman. The batsman can bend, escape from this. People will see like this. No, you will not get any response from the society. You will not get response from anyone. You escape from it. Alternatively, why can't you take a challenge for such bouncer? And the moment some opponent understand that bouncer is your weakness, they will try to give more bouncers. And every bouncer you will try to escape because it is your weakness. Why you should take it that as my weakness? Why bouncer should be my weakness? I understand when the bouncer comes, yes, I cannot send that, I cannot play a sixer. But at least I can try to score some 2 or 3 marks, 2 or 3 runs. Let me try that, no? Don't get panic. Don't never ever get panic because you don't have, I said, no emotions in the exam hall. Follow? Now let us read this question. On 1st of April 2017, A Limited acquired 80% of the share capital of S Limited. Okay, when you are thinking that this, you are, your mind in examination all you must be thinking 103 or 110. Strikes to you, one among the two. On acquisition date, the share capital and reserve stood 55 lakhs and 1,20,000 respectively. A Limited paid initial cash consideration of 10 lakhs. Additionally, it paid 2 lakh shares of 1 rupees each at 1.8 per share. Now you are becoming somewhere convinced that this must be 103 question. It sounds like 103 question. Yes. It was also agreed that A Limited would pay further sum of 5 lakh after 3 years. What is this consideration? Deferred consideration. And the cost of capital is 10%. Discount factor is 0.918375. So you know now what you need to be done. Then you are very much convinced that yes, this is 100% 103 question only. The shares and deferred consideration have not yet been recorded by A Limited. Yes, sir, what do you mean by this? Shares and deferred consideration is not yet recorded by A Limited. Now, deferred, you have not yet passed any accounting entry for it. Because deferred consideration you are going to pay after 3 years. So, A is thinking that I need not pass. And additionally, I have issued 2 lakh shares at nominal value of 1 rupees and have not yet passed any accounting entries. Leave it, no. You remember that question of chain holding? Sandhya, Usha and Nisha Limited. You remember there was one sentence. The capital profit is to be preferably adjusted against cost of control. What they are trying to tell? If you have made a capital profit, adjusted against cost of control. That sentence, entire sentence has no relevance in the entire solution. And if you see, that sentence is not there in your study material. So, you think, where you have come across this or what adjustment you need to do for this? Go with a very plain layman thing. What do you understand when you see this? Go with a very plain thing. See now, your challenge is what I am telling you. No? You don't understand. You think that, okay, I lost. I have to adjust it somewhere. I don't know what to do. This is what first thing comes to your mind. Now, read like a layman. You don't know accounts. You read this sentence. So, what should you do? Record. If you understand this much, at least you are free from that some feeling. You feel better. See, ultimately you are not understood. That is the truth. We don't know what is the relevance of this. What I have to do in the examination hall with this? If I don't know, I don't know. No. If I tend to make mistake, I am going to make mistake. This part I know it. The deferred consideration, I know it, I know it. This part I don't know, I don't know. So you struggle there, you put your stress on your mind, you think there, what it is going to hit you? So understand in a very layman language that, okay, not recorded by A, which I may have to record it. I cannot skip it. Okay, 1.8 is the share premium. Share premium. Now, the balance sheet is given on 31st March 2019 after 2 years. Oh, now the twist comes. Acquisition happened when? 1st April 2017. Did you observe that?
No.
That is a very basic and very fundamental. That means our prayer you forgot. Read the question carefully, you forgot. And it was a Yorker type of bouncer. First of all, it was a bouncer. On that Yorker was there. Because you were under a full impression that it is 103 question and you are geared up and somewhere you failed, they have given you 31st March 2019 balance sheet. That means they have mixed 103 with 110. Doesn't matter. Because even though they give 110, I start with 103. What difference it makes for me? Does it make any difference for you? What is your first step in 110? Goodwill. What is your first step in 103? Clear? How many marks? 15 marks. And see, what is the best first strategy? When you read this question, you understood it is a bouncer. Understood or not? Are you going to touch this? Do it later, no. Why you are touching first? Why you are spoiling your mood? Anyhow, all your objective was attempt 6 questions, 6 out of 6. Try next one. Go to question number 2. Start doing question number 2. Start doing question number 3. Finish question number 6. Come to this. I'm not telling you to leave this, but don't touch first. The first 1.5 hours, 60 marks, 20 marks each. It should be in your hand. Do something which you can do. This is one scope for you where there is you don't know much things. Like you have been doing tax audit all your 3 years of articleship. Suddenly company audit is given to you. You are excited, you are tempted to take that. But I suggest please wait. That is not the time. Understand that there is something called a priority. There is something called a timing. You have to be patient. Do this later. Because the moment you touch this, it is bound to go somewhere. That's why out of 15, whatever you get, it is bonus. No, at the end, when you are free of mind, lot of things are going to strike to you. And this is going to put a pressure on you. Very first question is going to put a lot of pressure on you. So look at the question, understand there is a bouncer, I can't do it. There are certain catches, leave it, go to the next. Do this later. Okay, now they have given you PPE, investment, inventory, cash receivable, share capital, retained earnings, whatever, all story on 31st March 2019. Further information, on the date of acquisition, the fair value of S Limited plant exceeded its book value by 2 lakhs. Oh, the plant had a remaining life of 5 years at this date. How much did you acquire? 80%, NCA is also there. The consolidated goodwill has been impaired by 2,50,000. How much is the goodwill? We don't know, which we have to calculate. But the goodwill got impaired by 2,50,000. A Limited values the NCI using fair value method. The fair value of 20% was 3,80,000. They have given me straightforward. Now, when the goodwill gets impaired, is it getting affected in my CFS?
Yes.
Should I give distribute my share to NCI also? Now, it all depends on which one. Should I give the share or not?
I should.
Full goodwill or partial goodwill method? Which method of goodwill valuation? Fair value measure. So when the goodwill 2,58,000 got impaired, are you not supposed to distribute that impairment loss to NCA also? Where that Trevor King is going to come? That means you have not gone through my format. That format has not come to your mind. Impossible. Impossible. You have to accept the truth that you are not, that my format has not come to your mind. Agreed? Not distributed means that format you have not gone through. Because very clearly in bracket I have told, under full goodwill method, the distribution has to happen. One more thing item was there. Deferred consideration was there 2 years back, which was supposed to pay next year. Did you consider the interest expense of the deferred consideration? Because you discounted, no? Something which was payable 3 years back, 3 years from now, you discounted and correctly calculated goodwill. I understand, I have seen that. Deferred consideration calculated. But after, did you calculate interest expense every year? Did you prepare an amortization schedule for that deferred consideration? Then, if you are not prepared, how my deferred consideration is going to become 5 lakh at the end of third year? And if there is an interest expense which is not there in the standalone, did you consider it in your consolidated CFS? Pure conceptual question. And none of this item, you don't tell me that, sir, I don't know. I am seeing for the first time. You knew it here, you knew it there, you knew it some other standard, you knew lot many places. The thing is, you have to bring everything at once and organize in a very systematic manner. Then you say, sir, this is nothing. And ulta, I'll tell you, beautiful thing. You are required to prepare CFS on 31st March 2019. At least this you would have seen. Then you would have striked that my acquisition was from 2017. Even though you have not seen the balance sheet date, you would have understood that I had to prepare a closing CFS. Now, what is the beautiful thing? Notes to accounts not required. What else I want? 15 marks. They tell me don't prepare notes to accounts expressly. Working notes, with the working notes only I can manage this. I can do this question very quickly. If I am conceptually clear as and when I read the very first part of my prayer, read the question, analyze the question, decide. That means in your mind only something must have mapped. Okay. Let us begin with the question. Don't lose your heart. You would have got marks for working. I see some goodwill and all you are working. Let us go with the thing. What did they ask me? Let us begin with our fourth prayer. What did they ask me? Consolidated. Can I go and start writing consolidation? No. What I want? Why I want goodwill? To prepare my consolidated closing balance, I need other equity. The life of consolidation, no? Do I have got that value of other equity? No. Why? I need some balances in other equity. What is that one balance which I need other in other equity? Opening balance of NCI. Do I have got opening balance of NCI? No, it is going to come from goodwill. Again, there is a goodwill impairment, everything. No, tell me, forget about it. Can you prepare other equity independently as a working note one?
Yes.
Yes, actually you can prepare. You don't need a goodwill for this. Because they have given, if NCA was not given, fair value and all you have to calculate, then yes. But even if they would have told you, goodwill is impaired by 10%. Here what they said, goodwill is impaired by 2,58,000, no? If they would have said goodwill is impaired by 10%, then goodwill would have been your first working note. Because without doing that working note, you cannot prepare other equity. Because you want the value of goodwill. But now if you see, goodwill working and my other equity working has got no relation at all. I can independently start anything. But I need both the workings. Okay, so let us go with our format will proceed. We will start goodwill working on when? 1st April 2017. Why? Because I need the opening consolidated balance sheet. When 2 years back, not 1 year back. One more catch you see. They didn't give me 1 year. 2 years back opening consolidated balance sheet I want. Yes. So start with the calculation of goodwill. So what did I start here? Purchase consideration. You have put very correctly. How much? Cash is there. How much?
10
lakhs. Then
shares,
how much? 2 lakh into 1.8, including share premium. Accounting entry wise, it is going to change in balance sheet. Here I say one figure called 3.6, but in balance sheet it is not 3.6. 2 plus 1.6. Then, is it the only purchase consideration? Deferred consideration. Now, is there anything in the step acquisition? Is there anything called contingent consideration, pre-existing relationship, ESOP to employees? You remember, it's coming from that format, 103 format. No, how much is my deferred consideration? 5 lakh into 0.75, 3,75,000. You must have got 1 mark for 17,35,000. Did you get 17,35? Yes, you must have got 1 mark. See, if you do, you actually, you are not in, you are interested in 15 out of 15 when you begin with the exam. You want 15 out of 15 for this question because it is a compulsory question. But when it comes to the last, after doing everything perfect, all other optional questions you have done very correctly, you are very happy, you are in a very good mood, then okay, palige bandadu panchamrita. One mark is one mark, enough. Even though it is compulsory, you are not bothered. Correct? You think, no, psychologically, you think what I am telling. So 17.35, then what else comes? Fair value of net assets, or is there any other item? Think, after purchase consideration, what comes? In goodwill calculation. NCI, how much? Will you get a mark for this, writing 3,80,000? No. Then, previous yield good is there? No. Then less? Fair value of net asset. What is my fair value of net asset? Okay. What is my book value of net assets? Yes. Which is equity capital, share capital of subsidiary 5 lakh and reserve of subsidiary on the date of acquisition, which is 1,25,000. And this is the basic, all the DEF question, Ramakrishna question, P&S question, professional and dynamic question, everywhere this is what we did. Plus what we do? Fair value increase. How much is fair value? The very first question you begin with, which you ignored, because none of the previous questions we had something like this. Every time they used to give me a balance sheet, from the balance sheet I used to pick. Every time you should pick from the balance sheet, but this balance sheet is a closing balance sheet. You can't pick from the closing balance sheet. You have to pick from the balance sheet on the date of acquisition. And all other examination question formats or study material question formats are different. Somewhere they have given you a balance sheet, somewhere they have given you a balance sheet at the end of the year, which you have to find out at the mid of the year. They have given you at the opening. How much is my fair value increase? 2 lakh. Okay, did I need to do any calculations? Because they didn't trick me. Plant and machinery was so much, building was so, buy so much, nothing, straightforward. So, I have got 8,25,000 as my net consideration. You got a goodwill of 12,90,000. Did you get? Maybe 2 or 3 marks you must be scoring by now with this goodwill calculation. And tell me, was it not simple? Was this not simple? And now with this goodwill acquisition, is it not you got an opening consolidated balance sheet in your mind? Did you not got an opening consolidated balance sheet? Yes. What should I do second? Other equity. For other equity, I know I need one amount, which yes, I can skip it. I don't know. In examination, you may skip it. In suggested answer, they have given you. It is? Sorry? Additional depreciation, not a big deal. I say 2 lakh into 1 by 5 or say 2 by 5 because for 2 years, no? Now, I am going to prepare amortization schedule for deferred consideration, which again, you can skip it. In one formula only you can calculate. Okay? So, how much is year 1, 2? It is a 3 year. What is the opening balance? 3,75,000. First year interest comes to 37,500. 4,12,500, second 4,12,500, second 41,250. Did you get this? The total interest on deferred consideration is 78,750. Did you get this number? Because in other equity you are supposed to put this, no? This is hitting the P&L, consolidated P&L. This is my expense, no? CFS expense, right? Which is not there in standalone of both. Deferred consideration is only in the CFS, that is what they say, that is what they say, that this is not recorded in by A Limited. Is A Limited is supposed to record this deferred consideration in standalone? Not required, no? Where it is going to come? Only in CFS is going to come, no, deferred consideration. Only in CFS. In standalone, what is the only thing going to come? The purchase consideration, cash paid, that's it. And maybe shares issued. Here one twist they have done, because they said actually this sentence would have been made more meaningful. The shares and deferred consideration not had been recorded by A Limited, that shares they should have striked it off. Because to purchase, actually I have issued 2 lakh shares. Correct? I have issued 2 lakh shares, no? Yes. Payable in which, whose balance sheet? Standalone balance sheet or consolidated balance sheet? In standalone balance sheet, the year end you pay in cash, no? Then it is going to come. That's why A will never record the deferred consideration in the standalone balance sheet. But they made one mistake. They said shares also not recorded. That is wrong. Because in today you have issued shares. And when you issue shares in your standalone, you would have recorded. So this is a contradictory. The deferred consideration have not yet been recorded by A Limited. That makes sense. Why? Because in standalone, he is not required to record it. Only it should come in the consolidated balance sheet, not in the standalone balance sheet. But the shares are going to come in standalone also, consolidated also. It's a confusing for you. Don't worry. Now, did you understand why I should prepare amortization schedule? Because if I am going to prepare a balance sheet, consolidated balance sheet on 31st March 2019, did you show a liability of 4,53,000? Is it a financial liability or an equity? Financial liability, because I have to settle in cash. Did you show it as a financial liability? This much balance? In CFS only, not in SFS. Okay, maybe this should fetch you 2 marks. The first step should fetch you 2 marks. Okay, next we will go to the other equity. Let us see what you have done. What I start with? Opening balance of NCI. When? On the date of acquisition. Now, how much is retained earnings of A? Let us go to the balance sheet of A now. How much today's day? How much is closing balance of retained earnings of A Limited? 14 lakhs? They are also smart. The balance sheet is given in thousands. Below all numbers are given in absolute. Okay, 14 lakhs. Then what else comes?
Returns of
What about the post profit of A Limited?
Sorry?
Profit made by A Limited in 2 years' time or this year? We had no profit made by A Limited, profit made by the parent. What is the profit? Very good. Now I am asking you. Yes, correct. What you said is correct. Because it is part of my retained earnings. I am not going to show. If I want to show separately, then I need opening balance of retained earnings on 1/4/2018. Is it available? Not there. So entire closing balance of retained earnings show, which includes profit also. Now I will ask you one more question. What is my post acquisition profit of S Limited? Beautiful. Perfect. How did you get?
3
lakh is my closing net assets minus 1 lakh 25 is my opening net assets on the date of acquisition 2 years back. So over a period of 2 years, the subsidiary has made a profit of 1 lakh 75. Who it should enjoy? How much for A? Amount 1,40,000 35,000. Then what else comes? Yes. Yes. I'm preparing cumulative consolidated balance sheet till date. I'm supposed to prepare a consolidated balance sheet as on date. So did they tell me to prepare a consolidated P&L? Then I had a challenge that I had to show only for 1 year. But when it comes to consolidated balance sheet, it is a cumulative effect till date. No. So what I'm going to show in my balance sheet, one figure of this. This includes entire cumulative effect. Then can I add it now? Total? Is there anything?
Depreciation.
Depreciation on fair value uplift. Nice word, no? Uplift. Okay, 64
and 16.
How did you get? Because 2 lakh is the total fair value appreciation. Life of the asset is 5 years into 2 years cumulatively. Then is there anything else? Goodwill impairment. How much? Under full goodwill method, because it's fair valuation, no? 258, whom should go? 206, 400, 51, 600. Is there any other item? Yes, obviously, because you can see one something blank, no? What comes only in consolidated balance sheet? This is all we are doing, consolidation adjustments. Deferred contribution, interest expense on deferred consideration. Whom? How much? How much? How much is my interest expense on deferred consideration?
Total of
1 year interest or 2 year interest?
2 years.
2 years. Whom should I give this? The amount is 78,750. 2 year interest. I prepared my amortization schedule. Okay, you didn't prepare. I prepared it. Okay, whom should I give? You think? Because this is not your challenge. Everybody faces this challenge. Even I have seen for the first time in the examination question. There's some concept called deferred consideration. And I never thought. Tell me, whom should I give? Should I give to NCI? Who has paid to whom? And this interest expense is on account of which transaction? Parent has paid to the earlier owners of S. Now what that amount has to do with the other owners of S? It's like this. Okay, you three, we three are there. You are the earlier owner who was owning 80%. Okay, Sana. And Shifali, you are owning 20%. Earlier, you two were the owners of one company. You are holding 80, you are holding 20. Now, I will buy from you and I will pay you something after 3 years. On that, I am going to incur some interest expense. Now, I will say, look, I bought from them. I have incurred an interest expense. Take one share of my interest expense, you also.
They are getting anything.
What you say? Nod your head. Okay, sir, you give. Because I am minority, no, please suppress me. I don't have anything. No. You should know law. There is an oppression and mismanagement chapter in law. You have to understand, if I am a minority or if I am an associate in some company, somebody is going to oppress me. What is the right I have? Now, what do you say? Will you take? And I ask you why? Why don't you take? I am a bossy. Why are you not taking? Tell. What is the reason? Law is there, let it be there. What is the reason? Tell me one convincing reason. Then you say, sir, what did you share with me when I took? That is your understanding, no? Otherwise, you should have paid the cash. You paid to Sana in cash, no? You are getting all benefits, huh? You are getting that finance, because this 5 lakh, you could have kept in a bank 3 lakh rupees. You would have got earned income on that nicely. Actually, you are enjoying that benefit of deferred consideration. That interest expense why you are sharing to me? This is not an NCI will say. Correct? So you are not going to give anything. Entire expense will be 750 belongs to your parent only. Are we done with the consolidation adjustments? Yes. So I have got 11,98,50 other equity balance as on date. And 3,47,400 is the NCI balance as on date, which may not match with the book value into 80% because originally I valued NCA at a fair value. Otherwise, at any point of time, book value into so and so, I'll get NCA value. Done? Full goodwill. Clear? Now, what should I do next? Balance sheet. Okay, one small working we'll do because they didn't say notes to accounts not required, correct? They said notes to accounts not required. Now, we will do some PPE balance. You remember in that questions I used to always tell you prepare. If you are going to prepare notes to accounts, skip this. But in this case, notes to accounts we are skipping. So, we'll do this. What is my opening balance? S limited balance, closing balance?
Closing balance is 15 lakhs.
Ah, okay, 1500 you say. How much is the fair value increase?
200.
How much is the depreciation you charged for fair value uplift for 2 years?
80.
So what is the book fair value of PPE balance? 16 lakh 20.
Yes.
Plus what is the parent PPE closing balance? 55 lakhs. So you get a closing balance of PPE at 71 lakhs 20,000. Yes, whole plant. So what? What? It's already charged. No, on the book value they were already charged, right? I'm doing only on fair value uplift. Then is there anything notes to be prepared? See, now you wanted a deferred tax, deferred consideration balance, financial liability. Did you already do one working note? You wanted one balance, no? That already we have done. Remember, before other equity, we have already done that. I know now what is the balance of financial liability. Okay, next I will go to current liability on 31st March 2019. What is A limited current liability? 12,50,000. Current liability of A limited and B limited? 6,50,000. Is there anything gets added to this current liability? Deferred consideration? 4,53,750. Why it's current?
Within 1 year.
Within 1 year, if it was then if we are to prepare balance sheet exactly at the end of first year, 2 more years are there to pay this 253, then this deferred consideration would have gone to non-current because I'm going to pay after 2 years, after 1 year from the balance sheet date. So you have got the closing balance of 2353750. Done? Yes. So we'll prepare the consolidated balance sheet of A limited. What I start with?
Asset.
Non-current asset, PP. What I'll do, I'll say working note number 2. How much is my balance? See, otherwise I would have given on the face of this. I created a working note. How much is my balance? 71,20,000. Then you have got, what else you have? Goodwill. Right. How much is my goodwill balance? 12,50,90,000 is the first goodwill.
12,90,000.
Yes.
Minus 2,58,000.
Okay. Where is the second effect of 2,58,000?
One is other equity, one is NCA.
NCA, very good. Now next I have got current assets. Under current assets you have got inventory. How much is my inventory?
5,58,100.
Then you have got financial assets.
Receivable.
Under financial assets receivable. 600, you add as 4 plus 2 and CC
250.
96,52,000 is your total assets. Clear? You have got any doubt in any of the numbers? Yeah, we'll finish in 2 minutes. Huh? Done. This is the last. You have got office? No office. No. Okay. Then we'll go to the equity and liabilities. You have got equity. Under equity, equity share capital. How much is equity share capital? Missed. Did I not issue 2 lakh shares on account of combination? No. 2 lakh shares I issued, right? So total 22 lakhs is my share capital. How much is my other equity? I'll give the balance here. Retained earnings how much?
Retained earnings is
11,98,50, that other equity balance plus securities premium, or securities premium you could have taken their own in that that working one and the same
1,60,000.
So you say 13,50,850 followed, no? Securities premium you could have taken there, or you say the other equity balance of the parent, consolidated balance as per step 2. I say step 1, step 2, and other working, not working. Then you have got non-current liabilities. How much is your non-current liability?
30 plus 4,
non-current. We didn't do working note for non-current. 34 lakhs. And how much is your current liability? From working note number 3, 2359. Tell me, was it not easy, simple? Within 25-30 minutes, solvable question, 30 minutes, not more than 30 minutes. Can't you solve this question in 30 minutes? And tell me, what was there in this? Simplified, no shock not required, that is not required, this is not required. See how much, what I say, I don't have any words to say. What do you say? Compassionate, that okay, within half an hour a question should get solved. Anyhow, we'll give some notes. Assumption. Since the question is not required to prepare the notes, okay, we are not shown the notes records. Don't write also, doesn't matter. This is what they have given, and it is assumed that the face value is 1 rupee. Why, I don't know. In the exam also they are given. Huh? They are not given. Nominal value. Okay, in the, if it is not given, then you may have to assume. If any question doesn't come, no, or you can say full 1.8 also, doesn't matter. No, you can't say that, because
given theory 1.8 is
fair market value. Yes, so that's it. Clear? Okay, so we have, you remember this question. We'll quickly go. You got some 10 minutes, no? Yes. So, we will revisit this question. What will be the accounting treatment of dividend distribution tax in a consolidated CFS of a partly owned subsidiary? 1. H Limited is holding 12,000 shares in S with the 60% holdings. Accordingly, that means 12,000 shares represent 60%. Accordingly, S Limited is a partly owned, and S Limited paid a dividend of 10 per share with the DDT of 20. So, your total number of shares is how much? 12,000 divided by 60%, which gives you 20,000. So you must have paid a dividend of 2 lakhs, out of which 80,000 belongs to NCI, and on that 80,000 you have paid the dividend distribution tax of 20%, 16,000. Now should the share of DDT paid by S Limited amounting to 24,000, how did you get 24? 2 lakh is the total dividend into 60% is my share into 20%. Should be charged as an expense in the P&L account of CFS? That is the first question. Now, in the second question, it is the same thing like previous question, everything is same. Parent paid 3 lakh to its shareholders with the 20% DDT, which is 60,000. Now, as per tax, they can, whatever 24,000 paid by the subsidiary here, the subsidiary paid 24,000, this can be claimed as a deduction, and the parent net paid only 36. Then we will go to the scenario 2b, where dividend is only 1 lakh is paid, on that 20,000 is paid. But how much deduction I am getting? 24,000. That means 20 I will not pay, 4 is gone for a toss. And will the answer be different if a dividend paid by an associate? Answer is same. So we are not going to discuss this, because this we already discussed. Same treatment we are going to give. Okay. Scenario clear, right? First, we will go with the journal entries. What accounting entry I had passed SFS as part in S Limited as part in its SFS?
Dividend cost account.
Dividend cost account, where they will show? SOC. Dividend distribution tax, how much? SOC. To bank, this is the accounting entry they had passed. Agreed? You have got any doubt? 30. Question number 30. Do you got any doubt in this question, in this journal entry? When they have passed in their standalone statement, this accounting entry they had passed. Now, what accounting entry parent must have passed in its standalone?
Receipt.
What is the accounting entry?
Bank
order. Hmm.
Bank
order
for
60% of. Whatever. 1,20,000. To what? What you will show dividend received from the subsidiary?
To P&L.
Why? Because it's 109 for me. It's a dividend income to P&L account. Bank to dividend income. Now let me prepare the consolidation. In a consolidation, the very first thing is I'm supposed to eliminate the dividend income and dividend expense.
Yes.
And balance dividend expense of the subsidiary I have to transfer to NCI. Yes. Now, what accounting entry in CFS I am going to pass? See, this is of SFS of S Limited, SFS of P Limited. Independently, they have passed. Now, I am going to, P is going to prepare a consolidated. I will debit dividend income, reverse.
Cancelled. 80,000 minus.
This is gone. Correct? With this debit credit gone. This out, that means what I am going to credit? Dividend cost, 2,00,000. This dividend cost, I am going to credit because this is debit, right? SOC, I will credit SOC. That's why you remember, when I prepare an SOC, dividend paid by subsidiary, I will put in bracket. Then one portion, I will put in NCI. You remember, no? Entire amount. Same format, that consolidation format. Null, and I will transfer to the NCI portion. So, I will pass an accounting entry, dividend income account debit, NCI account debit to dividend cost. So, dividend cost has gone with the dividend cost, correct? Can you see that, no? So, my dividend cost is gone, dividend income is gone, dividend cost is striked off, dividend income is gone from here. Now, you paid bank, I received bank, 1,20,000 automatically got net off, no? Should I pass any accounting entry for elimination? No, because I show closing balance of bank.
Yeah.
Now, what about this dividend distribution cost? You have to reverse it. You say to dividend distribution cost. How much you will debit to NCI? 16,00,000, 16,000. Now question comes, look. From the consolidated perspective, I have paid 40,000 rupees. See, dividend distribution cost has gone, debit, credit. I removed it. Out of 40,000 paid in cash by paying, raising a challan, 16,000 I charged to NCI.
Okay.
What is that 24,000? You say, sir, that is dividend distribution tax for your dividend. Correct? I will show in consolidated balance sheet, where is my dividend income?
It's
nullified. That means unnecessarily, because of lack of tax planning opportunity, lack of opportunities, lack of tax understanding, I told my subsidiary to pay the dividend and I am ending up paying 24,000 cash. I could have told subsidiary, no, please wait, don't declare dividend now. I didn't say, I have become a fool. So that 24,000 is my cost. So that's why in P&L account, dividend distribution tax is going to come in P&L account. This is my ultimate balance. So if you tell me one net effect entry in consolidation, I pass an accounting entry, NCI account debit, dividend distribution tax cost, P&L to bank, tell me, is this the entry I passed?
Wait, NCI 80 plus 16.
96.
80 is the dividend.
80 plus 16, NCI account. I will deduct it from NCI balance.
I will get that 80 plus 16.
80, NCI is dividend paid to NCI. I debit their account, no? Whenever I pay dividend, I deduct their account. That's why I am debit NCI.
Pay, okay.
Paid one, no?
So, together.
Together. And I paid unnecessarily 24,000, which is my cost. What has gone from me as a group? 2,40,000 has gone, but 1,20,000 I received it. So, net 1,20,000 has gone. So, I say at a consolidation level, this is my entry. And this entry, one item will go to P&L account. That's my first part of the question. They asked me, is there anything will go to P&L account? Yes, 24,000 is going to go because unnecessarily, there was no dividend income in my balance sheet. In my consolidated financial statement, but I ended up paying dividend distribution tax. Clear?
So how did you say like if that scanning was done, how could they avoid this?
I will tell you. Next question. Okay, so that's why I show that dividend income is 1,20,000 from standalone H. Adjustment is going to happen. Dividend paid, it is coming, going to come in SOC of standalone of S, which I am going to distribute, eliminate 1,20,000 and distribute 80 to NCI. Dividend distribution tax also same, out of 40, 24 I will distribute to adjust and 16, and that 24,000 is my loss which I charge to P&L account. Clear? Okay, now second part of the question, they asked me, parent also paid dividend of 3,00,000 rupees. Now this is the planning. Now I should tell, depending upon how much dividend I declare to my shareholders and how much dividend distribution tax I get as a deduction, I should tell subsidiary pay only that much dividend to me, so that my dividend distribution tax should get offset with what you pay. So as a group, I will not pay a single rupee extra, because whether it is a profit with you or with me, it is one and the same. Don't simply declare dividend. You declare only that much amount, so that I will recover my dividend distribution cost. Understood now what is tax planning? Okay. Now what my standalone subsidiary is going to pass accounting entry? Same thing. 2,00,000 dividend distribution to 2,40,000. What my parent is going to pass?
Dividend cost.
Okay. One thing is by default, bank account debit to dividend income. Same story. Another, they have paid the dividend also. What accounting entry they pass? They pass one bank to dividend income as usual.
That is from
subsidiary. Now dividend cost account debit, my cost is 3,00,000. On this 3,00,000, I am supposed to pay 60,000 dividend distribution tax. I am supposed to pay. But how much actually I pay? 3,36,000. I have claimed as a deduction. I am actually paying. So this is DDT payable for me, outstanding. I'll keep it in my balance sheet as outstanding. Follow? Now, in consolidated, first I am going to debit dividend. First I am going to reverse this dividend income. Gone. Then entire dividend cost of the subsidiary I am going to credit. 2,00,000, entire amount is credited, no? If I am crediting 2,00,000, debiting 1,00,000, 80,000 I charge to NCI. Correct? Now, dividend distribution cost was there, 40,000, SOC, I reverse it fully. I will debit 60,000 to NCI, and that amount of 24, did I not get a credit, which has got offset with the payable. So I will adjust that 24,000 with the dividend payable of my parent. In the standalone, they were selling payable, which is getting credit of this amount. Followed? So now at a consolidated level, what is the accounting entry I am going to pass? Now, same plus additional dividend, no? I am going to pass NCI account debit. See, my accounting entry will be NCI account debit 96, same story. Dividend cost to me how much? 3,00,000. Parent. On that dividend distribution tax was 60, which will go to SOC. On what 3,00,000 I am supposed to pay. Only I don't pay in cash. I will claim what they have claimed. So to bank, net amount 4,56,000 went. 1,20,000 from my subsidiary. 2,40,000 minus 1,20,000, how much? 1,20,000. Plus 3,36,000. 4,56,000. That's it. Now, did any single amount went to P&L account as my cost?
No.
No.
Here
we recognize it? Yes.
DDT cost is 60.
60, because my parents' DDT cost. But parents' DDT cost I will not take to P&L, no?
No, not to P&L, but actually I paid in cash only 36,000.
And balance they have paid, no? Balance 24 they paid, no? It is there in 2,40,000. 36, your cost is 60.
Group cost is 60
group cost is 60. Yeah, exactly. Group cost is 60. Out of group cost, 36 you paid, 24 my subsidy repaid because you claimed as a deduction. So at a CFS level, on the dividend what my subsidiary paid to you, no cost went outside. Entire amount you got as a deduction. So will you debit anything to P&L account? Nothing. That's why if you see the final effect, no amount has gone to P&L account. In the first case, 24,000 went to P&L because you didn't declare the dividend and you ended up paying on an eliminated dividend, you paid 24,000. You eliminated dividend, right? But you ended up paying 24 on that. Lack of planning. Perfect. That is why. Now that's why you say that my dividend income is 1,20,000, which gets adjusted and eliminated. On this dividend income, they pay the dividend distribution tax, but I claim as a deduction. So P&L nothing is going to go. In the SOC, I pay dividend of 3 lakh. Subsidiary pays 2 lakh, out of 2 lakh, 1,20,000 gets eliminated. This is gone, debit credit.
3,80,000 is NCI.
3,80,000 is not NCI. Out of 3,80,000, 80 is NCI, 3 lakh to my shareholders. I paid 3, no? To my shareholders. 80 will go to NCI. When it pays, comes to dividend distribution tax, I never paid. I paid only 36. Subsidiary paid 40. So 36 plus 40 is 76 is what I have paid as a group.
No.
I was supposed to pay 60, correct?
Yeah.
Did I pay 60?
No.
Subsidiary actually paid 40 before me only. What is my total cost of the group, you tell me?
60 total.
Correct. That's 60, no? Because out of 76, 16 you will give to NCI, no? How much is your cost? In SOC, out of 76 is what you have paid in cash. 36 you paid, 40 NCI paid. Agreed?
No, okay, I didn't get 76.
See here, no. You paid how much? 40.
Okay.
How much you are supposed to pay? 60. But you paid only 36. 40 plus 36, that 40 is sitting in this. 36 is sitting in this. Actually, in cash, how much dividend distribution tax you paid? 76. But out of 76, how much will go to your SOC? Parents SOC, only 60 is going to go. Balance 16 is going to sit in NCI.
That NCI.
Yes. Clear? Now, second scenario, what if I have distributed only 1 lakh as P&L? Yes. First scenario B, same story. Dividend 42. You pass two accounting entry, one to receive the dividend, but the second dividend is what you paid is only 1 lakh. On this 20,000 you are supposed to pay. Did you pay that? No, because subsidiary has already paid 24,000. But how much maximum benefit you can get? 20. Okay, no, you keep it in dividend payable. Now let's prepare a consolidated entry. What is going to happen in a consolidated entry? Dividend cost of the subsidiary, entire amount you will reverse.
Okay.
And you reverse this income also and balance your transfer to NCI. Now dividend distribution tax of subsidiary, 40,000 what they paid in cash, I'll credit. Out of 40, 16 I'll transfer to NCI. Then there is a dividend payable in your parent, 20. I will reverse that also because you need not pay, no? On this 1 lakh, you are supposed to pay 20 because you are claiming a credit. You will not pay this entire 20. But what you credited is 24. What you credited is 40, given to NCI 16. You adjusted 20. Did you show any dividend income in your consolidated statement? No. But you ended up paying 4,000 extra to taxation authority.
That is what my subsidiary will pay.
Subsidiary as a group. Somewhere from your cash is gone, no? Now, if you are intelligent, if the parent would have been intelligent, what parent would have told? You would have told, don't declare 2 lakh. You declare only so much so that your dividend distribution tax, my share, comes to 20,000. You follow my point? You would have told, so that whatever you pay, that I will claim as a deduction, so that this is not going to come. Extra will not pay from the group. If parent would have been, but parent is fool. Parent said, okay, whatever comes to your mind, you declare. Subsidiary ended up declaring some 2 lakh. and they pay 40,000 rupees. And my share is in that 40 is how much? My share is how much in that 40? 24,000. My share was 24,000. And here I declare 20. And taxation gave me a deduction of only 20. What I should have told the subsidiary, see, don't declare 2 lakh. Declare less amount so that you end up paying only 24,000 my share. So tell me how much should have been the dividend in that case. Can you tell me? If you have to pay dividend distribution tax of only 24,000 to the equal of parent share, 20,000. So if you are supposed to pay only parent share 20,000 divided by 60%, 33.333, this should have been your total dividend distribution divided by 0.2. So you should have paid dividend of 1,66,667. I will tell you. See, if you would have paid here, see how it would have happened. If you would have paid 1,66,667 dividend, on this, how much dividend distribution tax you would have paid?
20%
into 0.2, 33,000. Okay. 333. How much cash you would have paid? 2 lakh. You would have paid cash of 2 lakh, right? Subsidy would have paid cash of 3. So your dividend distribution, dividend cost is 1,66,667 and your total dividend distribution tax is 33,333. How much is your parent share in this 33,333?
20,000.
How much is your NCA share? 13,333.
Yes.
Now, when you paid that 20, did you not get a full set off for 20 what you paid? NC is not bothered. I will charge it. I will deduct it from their balance. No, that is not my cost. What I pay to NC is not my cost because I am going to deduct my liability balance. But what I have paid, if it is exactly getting offset, that means this amount will not come to P&L. No, you will not pay extra money. As a group, we will see to it that we will not pay any dividend distribution tax on the subsidiary's dividend to parent. And this is called a planning. As a CA, this is what you are supposed to suggest to the management. Correct? No, management is, I want cash. Only cash only in the birthday. Kodi, tell the subsidiary to declare the dividend. Are a fool. There's a tax effect on it. So, what big deal? Now you would have saved 4,000. It may be 4 crores. It may be 400 crores. You understood, no? What I did here? You understood, no? How did I get 1,66,033 backward calculation? How did I do it?
Yes.
So at a net effect, I am going to get NCI because I didn't do this planning. I am a fool. NCI, I am debiting 96. Dividend cost comes to 1 lakh. How did I get 1 lakh? Dividend cost? Sorry, dividend cost is 1 lakh, mine. And subsidiary share is sitting in this 96. Now dividend distribution cost is 20,000, my share only, parents cost is my dividend distribution cost, and dividend distribution cost to P&L is this 4,000 and to bank is 2,20,000. How did I get 2,20,000? 1,20,000 from here net plus 1,00,000, 2,20,000. Understand this, spend time on this. That's why I prepare this note telling dividend income I got 1,20,000. I adjusted it. I paid 1,00,000, subsidiary paid 2,00,000. 1,20,000 intercompany elimination happened. 1,80,000 is the final I will show in my CFS. Of this, 80 belongs to NCI, 1,00,000 belongs to my shareholders. Dividend, I didn't pay anything because I got a set off. But subsidiary paid 40, out of which 36 is what finally going to come. Of 36, 16 will go to NCI, 20 is my cost in SOC, but 4,000 will go to my P&L. Clear? Yes, so with this, we are done with all 60 questions. Four major chapters we have covered in category A. Which all those? 109, 110, 115, 103. 116, I don't say major. If you want to give the designation that major, you can give lease. For me, it is a B category. These four are A category. Now, two more are there, we'll do later. Now, did you feel that confidence in consolidation basics, theory, consolidation procedures? Chain holding, subsequent change in NCI, loss of control. only five aspects we are going to cover. Yes, tell me. Then what? That's what I'm telling you. At least out of 15, sure shot 8 marks would have got for goodwill calculation, somewhere you do the deferred consideration, amortization schedule, something here, there, you are going to score the marks. And that's why your strategy should be never touch such questions beginning. Because your initial, no, you always go with the psychology of scoring 15 out of 15, which is not going to happen. But if I tell you, if you are going to score 8, at the end, after doing everything very well, happy, no? That's it. What do you need then?
And we lose confidence, sir.
You lose the confidence, no?
We can't, if you know other questions also.
Other questions also gone for a toss, no?
Yes, sir.
That's the examination practice you need to have. Clear? So, this is the 6 things we covered. How many important questions in this 60, which you have to practice 4 times on priority? 27 questions, which we give. I think one more question we added somewhere at the end. Question number 46. Deemed loss of control. We added one question. Question number 46. Mark it. Now, okay, let us go through one by one. Let us see important in that. See, concept of control. Little angel. This is fine theory. You can just read it. Nothing to be solved. TK, weapon business. Remember? Again, concept of control. You can read it and go. Gamma with investment entity, concept of control. Read it and go. Uniform policy depreciation. You can read it and go. That means again, 27 is also not so big number. Certain all theories are there. There are certain questions which you have to solve 4 times without seeing. You may have to remember those numbers also. Steps, sequence, everything you should be solving. Uniform policy on inventory valuation theory. I gave important because it's some nice, unique question. Yes, this is you have to solve. Airtel PP, market highly probable. In that, I have given one new column, no, highly probable. Market, because you have to practice, write and practice. Unrealized profit on selling of the business equipment. Journal entry we have to give, that revenue journal entry, NCI and goodwill calculation for case 1, 2, 3, 4. It is okay, not a big deal, in your inter only you have done it, he is telling that it has come in your inter, no? So I will say okay, not that much, huh? This you solve it because I have given every adjustment there. This is my own question, not from examination, but every single fair value adjustment, your upstream transaction, downstream transaction, everything I have given. Practice it. Now, Blue Heavens and Orange County. Question number 28 is only important because other two questions are you only told that day. Will it come in the question? Because plain basic consultation had to be done. So, this mark it important. I don't know how many times you mark this. So mark this big consolidation problem very important because it's the only one question which has not come till now. Everybody is going to leave it by default, telling it is not going to come. But I am telling it part of the question may come. Now DDT accounting in CFS, just now we discussed, no?
Yes.
This has to be practiced. So how many questions we found? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 questions we found in the first slide. Then consolidation of 100% subsidiary. Yes. Consolidation with NCI, yes. Chain holding, yes. Undisputedly, we have to solve this. This is all the DEF question, PP at the mid of the year, all those things. Change in NCI without loss of control. Okay, simple. Okay, simple. You can just, you see that. If you want, you can mark it important. I say you can read it also, go fine. Advice on gain or loss on partial sale. Yes, you have to mark it. You remember, breakup you have to give in the gain or loss.
Some.
Question number 44, then loss of control in SFS and CFS, fine, but this breakup, this is that loss of control with the breakup, and this is that capital reserve examination question of Ind AS to AS 21, I don't say, just read it and go. Loss of control with multiple transactions, this is also more theory, once you read you understand. Recycling, yes, important, yesterday journal entry. Loss of control, preparing the balance sheet, fine, not a big deal, but you can just prepare once, simple thing. Convertible preferences is a theory. So, how many questions? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 questions. So, 7 plus 5, 12 questions. Parent consolidating subsidiaries associate, O and N, yesterday we discussed. Deferred tax, loss on loan, yes, important, but it's already come for examination. Consolidation of balance sheet after 2 years, yes, important, because you come for exam. Conceptually, you will practice.
That's a very nice question.
Nice question, beautiful question. 2 questions. So, how many questions in total? We discussed 5 plus 7 plus 2. 5, 7, 14. So out of 27, 14, out of 60, 27 are important questions with the theory. 14 is highly probable questions which you have to sit and solve. On priority solve these 14 questions. Then read this other balance question. And then if you are interested, look solve other.
So you cover important questions like what revision is done?
Not immediately, from time to time till your exam.
Once,
maybe
once you read, one revision is done.
Once you read, one revision is done. Keep that in mind. So when you are sitting, okay, you are finished with my class. Don't solve these questions during my class because we are already solving. Once you do somewhere in between your time, you do one round of that important question. One round of revision is done actually. You do second round of revision is done. Whichever, whenever your exam is, maybe in your November 22. By November 22, before that, before you sit for that 6 months leave or 3 months leave, you solve all these four times. Done, no, your FR is done. You see that revision will go like this it is going, page after page, because every single question you know that, four times you have solved it. Difficult questions. See, if difficult questions are gone out, then what remains? You have got a lot of time, but don't go for parties and all, picnic and all. Have that frame of mind. Try to gain more knowledge. Try to do more practice. By this, every subject, this has to, strategy has to be applied for every single subject. Yes, I believe consultation you find easy. In principle, simple. Will you say that I am not going to study this? You can study this, and you see, you know, so easy thing. Yes, so thank you. We will continue in the next standard. Yes, hope you have got an insight into how, what should be your strategy. So I will tell you what happened during my examination in costing. I left standard costing because after some level of understanding material variance, the price variance and all, I could not understand much. So I left that. The very first question came for some 16 marks in costing. See, we didn't have that much of time to, like 15 minutes extra time was not given to read the question. It was 3 hours reading and solving. The moment I saw the very first question, I believe that is purely grace of God, because there was no strategy at that time. What did I do? I saw it without waste of time, without single minute. I just skipped to the next question. Went on solving. See, my total attempt for of the paper itself is for 84 marks, first thing. I went on, at the end I could not find the time, even some 5-6 marks I left. So I can say somewhere my attempt itself is in 80 marks. Now, I got exact 40 marks in costing when I was thinking I am not going to clear. Anyhow, that is also grace of the God. Here, when I reflect myself, I realized one thing. On the very first question, if at all I would have spent 1 minute thinking, oh, what is this question? Can I try to solve it? Can I put my mind into it? Which I would not have been able to solve. Unnecessarily, I would have wasted time. I would not have got the time to get 1 mark at the end. See, today I got 40 marks and I would have spent 5 minutes on the first question. I would have lost 1 or 2 marks on the last question which I attempted. I must have done it very well. So, I tell you one simple strategy, leave out your emotions in the examination hall. Didn't you, go to the next. Complete everything, then go back to the question which you have left and then try to solve it, but not at the beginning. Yes, friends, thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed my video. Please like it, subscribe it and share it, and tell me your comments and feedbacks so that I'll post more videos like this. Yes, thank you very much.